Hello and welcome to another episode of Scavenger Life. This is episode number 286 at scavengerlife.com.
So Ryan, do you think it was a mistake that we brought up politics last week?
No.
Okay.
I was surprised that it was brought up. Well, look, when you started talking about it, I was like, oh, this is going to be something. It's going to be intense.
I honestly did not think it was going to be a big deal.
Really?
But, you know, maybe it was a problem. I'm not sure. But, you know, these changes affect us.
I think it's emotional for everybody.
And, you know, as people who do not have jobs, we don't work for anyone, where we work for ourselves, you know, stuff like that affects us. And, you know, this is not a business site. Like, some people seem very angry at us. Would say things like, we're not going to listen to it anymore.
Right.
You know, like, it's a threat for a free podcast. Like, all right, I mean, you know, I'm sorry they're not going to, but, you know, this isn't a business site. They said, don't talk about politics on your business site. I mean, this is a podcast and a blog about our way of life.
Like, right.
We're, like, documenting our lives. Like,
right.
This kind of thing, like when we're old people, like, we'll have this documentation of what we were doing week to week. I don't know if it'll be interesting, but it's, you know, how many people get to do that? It's almost like an audio diary, and the election was
part of our life. I mean, the other thing too is that I hope people remember and understand is, like, we're telling you what we do every day and our opinions on how, you know, eBay is, you know, Amazon is. I mean, how to handle situations with your customers. This is just my opinion. I'm not an eBay official.
Right.
I'm just telling you what I do in my daily life and what works for me.
Right.
So that translates to other things we talk about.
So we do appreciate the people who listen to our opinion without anger, you know, and the people that were willing to ask us questions of why we believe what we believe. And, you know, we may not all agree the direction the country is going to go in, but we should at least be honest enough to kind of chart the coming changes. And that's something I thought that was good. People were willing to go and without, you know, a lot of emotion, just kind of say why they were excited, what they hope was going to happen. And I think that's good. So that way, over the next 4 years, we can then see what actually does happen. Because there are some things that it's not about politics. It's about our lives, about healthcare, about changes in taxes, about how, you know, if there are going to be trade embargoes and trade wars. And I mean, I don't know. I mean, all these things could happen, so that can affect our business. And we need to have some kind of safe space to talk about that.
Right.
I also actually appreciated hearing from the people who voted for Trump who were really positive. I mean, in some ways, I was definitely bummed. And so I'm not sure if I'm super positive, but people on the blog who I respect were saying why they're excited and why they're actually not worried, and it's good to hear that.
Look, I think it is very important for us to be able to have constructive conversations about any subject. That's why I love our community, because I feel like people with different opinions on how to handle customers, how to handle returns, how to buy inventory, we all learn from each other. I mean, you know, there's so much that I've learned from people. So to hear the other side of, you know, the argument in a logical, unemotional, I mean, everyone was getting a little bit emotional, of course. But I think that's really important because I don't think that happens normally in other places. It just doesn't. That's why we don't go on the eBay forums.
You know, we all,
you know,
the whole point of us starting this little community and the podcast was because we could find no place where people talked about eBay in a its respectful way to
and
each
rational
other.
Way
and talk and being able to talk about all kinds of things that affect our its business. And I was only laughing because I don't know who was more surprised. The people who didn't know that we weren't Trump supporters, or for me to realize how many people who
listen
hear
to
us are Trump supporters. I mean, people who, you know, we talk to on a regular basis were Trump supporters. I had no idea.
I mean, because we generally don't talk about those
it's
things.
It's just so
you know?
Interesting. But as we said, the whole point of last week's post was we're getting ready for anything. And that's, right. I think, a good philosophy for any time there's big change coming.
Yeah.
All right. Break.
Break that.
Okay. Ryan has been very busy working on improving the forum.
I spent most of yesterday trying to change up some of the formatting. Many people, including ourselves, wanted a darker font, a bigger font that's easier to read in certain places. So that happened.
And a less white space.
Less white space. There was a lot of what we call in the web CSS world, there's a lot of padding around all elements. So there was a lot of white space. I tried to tighten that up a little bit. I changed the background on the blog. I've been playing with that. The cool thing about blogs, look, is like you can make changes on the fly. Like you can just do things as you go. So
that's a great thing about a content management system.
WordPress. You know, you can go in there and you can adjust things just instantaneously. So if you have the knowledge, you can do it.
So we actually made, you know, because when we started the new forum, I started a category or a topic and people were posting what they wanted to see happen. And right. We made a list out of those. We knocked off a bunch of them.
Yeah.
We have some more to do. Some of the stuff we can't do.
Right.
It's PHP stuff.
Yeah, it's like actual.
So the guy that helped us transfer the blog, Eric, we're going to actually pay him to hopefully be able to tackle some of the deeper functions and fixes that people ask for and the things that we want too.
So. Right.
But, you know, I've been, you know, hanging out on the It's forums when people
post. Yeah, me too.
And it's cleaner. It seems very efficient and I like it. And I actually tried the search the other day and I found something someone had talked about. So
yes, that's so awesome. There's one section of the forum that I made the section, but I just revisited it and it's the meetup section. So if you guys are in a certain area and you want to try to do a meetup, go on that section of the forum and post where you're at and where you want to meet. There's already one that's going to happen, I think, in DC. Like DC area soon. So go on there and check it out.
Yeah, it's totally self-organizing. I mean, we have nothing to do with it. But if people want to meet up, if they want to go scavenging together, people want to tell each other about different events in their town, to share their trade secrets and honey pots. The other thing I was thinking was, and I don't know if this would ever be interesting for people, if there are scavengers who are looking for people to list for them or take its photos, I was just thinking maybe they could use that area to
find people.
To find people. Yeah. I mean, maybe, I'm assuming most people that hear us, they're kind of like self-made people and they're kind of in charge of their own business. But maybe there are people out there who are hearing us who have a store but are like, I wouldn't mind just a listing for somebody else for a guaranteed amount of
every
cash.
Once in a while, part-time, whatever.
Or ship or, you know, and I know we just kind of are trying somebody out and other people seem interested. So maybe we can be the helpful connector of people who think like all of us.
Right.
You guys could get together and maybe make something happen.
Yeah, so go check out the meetup section in the forum. It's on the list of forum topics.
Okay, let's talk about eBay this week for us.
Yeah.
It is official that this year we are making less money.
Yes.
It's really, because we're into like the end of November. I mean, this is like the last month of 2016.
Yeah.
We're definitely making less money than we did a year ago.
Right.
I mean, according to our dashboard, the new seller dashboard, which I actually like.
Yeah.
It says we're 8.6% down.
Feels like more than that.
Yeah. So why is that? I don't think it's because someone at eBay has looked at our account over the millions of others and are pushing a button and turning us off. I mean, I've been kind of, you know, feeling that this is probably why. We've been focusing on listing our death piles this past 12 months, you know?
Yeah.
We've been busy with other things. We realized we had all this backlog of inventory and we're like, well, let's just focus on listing stuff we already have.
Right.
And anyone that has a death pile knows, oftentimes, because it's a death pile, and we call it a death pile, is that pile of kind of unwanted, uninteresting stuff that you're just putting off you know, going through. They're a death pile because it's often the stuff that's like not as interesting.
Low dollar.
Not worth as much money.
But you're still willing to sell it. You're not going to throw it away.
It came in like a box lot. So you listed the really cool item, but the other 10 items are now over here. Yeah. Or it's a bunch of clothes that aren't as interesting. And so we've been focusing on doing that stuff. And that means the good part is we've spent a little on inventory this year. But then the second thing is we've mainly been listing items that are worth $30 or less.
Yeah.
We have 4,500 items in our main store, and so the way eBay shows it to you is in a page of 200 items.
Right.
So we have about 24 pages, each page with 200 items. There are only two pages where items are worth over $100. So that's 400 items out of 4,500 items are worth over $100. And that's
crazy.
That's why we're not making as much money this year, is because we have not been scavenging higher dollar items.
Yep.
And so it's interesting just to talk about. I mean, it's not bad. We're still making good money. And we've had to spend our time doing other things and working on our rental business and, you know, at auctions every day. And because all this stuff takes time.
Yeah.
What it shows me is the decisions that we make a year ago affect us now.
Yeah.
And we'll feel that effect until we
start. For a while.
Till we start scavenging higher dollar items and feeding that into our pipeline, you know?
Yep.
So my question is, how will we change this?
Well, your theory on how to change it was to start scavenging at higher end places. Go to higher auctions, go to higher end estate sales. And we can totally do that, you know?
Yeah.
We have to have the time to do it. And right now, we just don't have the time with everything that's happening.
Right. We're in the middle of renovating a second edge rental. And I don't think that will happen till like March, really.
Yeah.
Because...
And we still have death pile. I mean, we still really like have a bunch of stuff that has to get done.
We see the light at the end of the tunnel.
Yeah, sure. Though, it helps to have an employee.
But really, I mean, that's the thing. You know, scavenging does take time. I mean, those people that go to thrift stores every day, or they hit, you know, a couple auctions every week. Or, you know, I mean...
That's time consuming.
It takes time. And where we live, to go to one of those places, it's often half an hour or an hour drive.
Yeah.
If not more, because we live way out of the boonies. You know, even spending a day... I mean, we used to do this a lot more, like on a Saturday, waking up early, driving around to, you know, and we would have a list of the yard sales to hit. I mean, that's an all-day endeavor,
it's a thing.
You know?
It's a whole thing.
But that's when you find really good stuff, too.
Yeah.
That's when you also find all the kind of junkier stuff that becomes death pile. So, you know, it's all part of one and the same.
Yeah.
Okay. We figured out something very important this week for our business because of another member of the community.
Yes.
Scheduled listings.
Okay.
What was the problem?
Here's the issue. Working with my helper, we'll do a bunch, say, like right now she's working through a whole tub of belts. There are so many belts. So we're like, let's make 50 belt, you know, drafts so that once you make the draft, you can just take the picture on the mobile device. On the iPhone, and it's attached to that draft. And the issue was she could only see 30 at a time. So I would have to consistently be keeping up with her the whole time. And sometimes I would get behind because I'd have to run to the house and do something or whatever. Like, and I'd be getting behind and she'd be like, oh, I can't like get to a new draft. And I'm like, this is crazy. I don't understand how we can figure this out. But I believe it was Vic on the forum said, what you can do is to get it out of the drafts, you can do a scheduled listing. You can have her like do everything that you want to do like on the draft and then schedule it for like whatever, a few days later. And then they're not going to charge you that 10%, that 10 cent fee until it actually gets posted. But if you... It's almost like an active draft. So if you have your scheduled listings, say I have like 20 scheduled listings, and I go in and I change it from scheduled to post immediately once I hit, you know, publish or whatever it's called. they're not going to charge you that 10% fee. That 10 cent fee only happens if you keep the schedule till later.
And then it automatically lists.
It automatically lists in a couple days or 2 hours or whatever, and then they charge you that 10 cents. So that's the great thing. As she's getting through drafts, I can just throw it over to scheduled listings. It gets it out of the draft list. So there's not like 100 drafts. It's like each draft goes away to the, you know, holding pattern, which is awesome. I was kind of thinking, like, there's got to be a way to do this. But I just figured once you say scheduled listing, they're going to charge you.
Right. So anyway, that's why we love the community, because we learn stuff like this. I mean, that's a very big deal and is making us learn to be more efficient. And this will allow our helper to actually list items without actually making them active, but yet still be able to create more and more of these without there being a backlog. Because at this point, we've only been working with her for not even a month yet. We don't feel comfortable with having her price stuff and then press go.
Right.
You know, list.
Yeah.
We still want to be able to get it into an area where Ryan can
I can look through it, make sure all the...
And again, some people have been telling us, well, what we do is we give our person a tub.
Yeah.
They photograph it and list it, and we just tell them list everything at $20. And we get that, and that makes a lot of sense. Our methods really aren't quite like that just yet. But, you know, so the scheduled listings really is something good.
What I'm going to try to do this week is, because she's not writing titles right now, I'm going to try to get her to really write titles and do item specifics as much as possible, so that when I am in that scheduled listing, I can just put the price in, and then it's just ready to go.
Right, we're kind of taking her step by step.
Yeah.
You know, photographs first. She now knows how to make, you know,
a draft.
She's been writing some titles, and, you know, we're going to get her into the process, and then as she gets better and better, we'll throw more and more at her. And then hopefully we get to the point where she just does, we can give her a box of stuff and she just does it all.
She just does it.
And I mean, obviously the amazing thing would be is if she could then be a researching
and pricing.
Price it correctly.
Yeah.
You know, it's Christine on the blog said, why not just give her the lower dollar item? So she can never really make an error in pricing. And that's a good idea too.
Yeah.
But, I mean, I think the other thing, too, is, you know, for us, we don't really know how interested she is, you know, like
we've
kind of talked to her about this, but we don't know if she just sees this as just like quick money side job.
Right.
Is this something she would want to do for the next 5 years?
Right.
And does she want to take on more and more its responsibility, and we would pay her more to do that? So it's kind of like the thing. We're kind of feeling her out. She's feeling us out. And it's not something where I want to just, like, sit her down and have this, like, really serious, like, conversation, you know.
Like, you're going to take over our
business.
What
do you want to do with your life?
Yeah.
So it's good.
Yeah.
The other question I wanted to ask was, and we were kind of talking about it in the forum, does anyone use, like, InkFrog or 6bit or another one of those third-party softwares that kind of fits into eBay, where you can give a helper or a worker access to list, but they don't have access to any other part of your eBay account or PayPal. And, you know, it's where you have to pay every month and all that.
Yeah.
I just wonder if anyone uses any of those services and which ones they like and if they think it's worth it.
Right. I would love to know. Right now, I just have her signed in on my devices. It's not like she takes this stuff home and can buy stuff on her account. So,
I mean, I was actually thinking about starting another category on a forum where we could all document things we wish eBay would do that it doesn't do now. I mean, I don't know if anyone from eBay ever hears this or reads anything that people say, but maybe if we started putting a place where we started documenting that stuff, and maybe that link would drift into eBay Central.
Well, like, it's kind of like you're saying, one thing that would be great with eBay is to give someone access to your account, but limited access.
Right.
You know?
Like, can you make a user on your eBay account? You know, that...
Like, I'm the admin, they're the assistant or whatever.
Like, that would be a very cool thing.
I think a lot of people would use
that. Another thing I've said was, I wish eBay would tell you if someone is a repeat customer.
Oh, they like, never do
they have that.
That
information, and I know in GoDaddy it kind of tells you if someone has
the
bought
same
again.
Name.
But it's only if it's the same name. There could be two Robert Smiths, you know.
That actually happened. There was a David Smith, and they're like, this person's bought from you before, and I double-checked it. I'm like, it's two different people.
So, and, you know, it's too bad eBay doesn't do that. Like, this person bought something from you 6 months ago.
And it was this item. You're like, oh, this
and
person.
And maybe if there was something we could do, like, you know, send them a special as message or something like that. I don't know. Anyway, those are things. So, maybe I'll put that category up there if anybody else cares.
Yeah.
So right now, our assistant, our helper, our worker, this person who we are bringing into our eBay life, she now takes photos of about 15 items per hour.
Yeah.
We've been kind of documenting, like when she leaves after 3 or 4 hours, we count how many things
she got done.
So that's just photographs. So she photographs 15 items per hour. And I'd like to see what happens when we get her to photograph and list.
That number's going to go down.
And so far, it's worth it. You know, we've already sold enough from the items that she's worked on to more than cover paying her.
Yeah.
But then we have all this inventory now in our store that will eventually sell.
Right.
So.
It's filling the pipeline. I mean, you're just like filling it as full as possible.
Right. But, you know, it's nice to see things sell the same day, next day, same week.
It's great.
That she handled.
Right.
So
you know
we aren't just spending all this money up front.
Right.
Know?
Yeah.
All right. Let's talk about our numbers for this week. This is after Black Friday, which we have never seen as huge eBay sales days, but, you know, we did okay. So we actually sold 54 items this week, which is a lot of items for us. Like, that's a lot of...
Yeah.
You know, volume. And we made about $1,600 on our main store. So the reason why those two numbers correspond is because our average price was about $29.
Yeah.
So it was just really bread and butter, grinding it out. Like yesterday, we actually sold quite a bit, like 12 things, but there was like $15, $30.
Stuff's on sale too. We have a sale on our store.
And that's something I noticed too, is that I see a lot of people doing sales. I see people doing like half price sales.
Yeah.
I'm just like, wow.
That's crazy.
People are just giving stuff
away. Look, I have a sale category and it's 40% off right now. So
right,
I can't judge those people.
But that's really old stuff, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. It's like, I mean, so I don't know. I mean, I guess that's the free market. The more people do this, everyone's like pushing prices down. But it is what it is. And then on our second store, we made about $400.
That's not bad.
So, you know, overall, we made about $2,000 last week. And
I'm not complaining about that.
Although,
not complaining.
My hat's off to the people who are saying they're making $3,000 and $4,000
a week.
Those seem to mainly be the clothing people or guys like Steve that are selling
the high,
you know,
stuff.
A handful really high end. You know, if you're making $3,000 or $4,000 a week, my hat is off to you. You know, that is amazing.
Your invisible hat.
That is amazing. Yeah.
Yes.
Okay, things we sold this week. A lot of bread and butter stuff, but a couple things we'll talk about is we sold a urinal for $130.
Now, this was funny. We were at a thrift store in one of the big towns near us, and there's this room that has furniture in it. And I go up there and just kind of browse around. It's junky.
It's a junky Salvation Army.
It's almost like a like dorm room furniture, just like old office furniture. It's horrible. But I saw a urinal on the table, and it was a Kohler. Now, I'm a big fan of Kohler. I love their stuff. I want it in all my houses and stuff like that. So I was like, let's just see how much this is. It's going to suck to pack. The thing weighs like 40 pounds, you know? And it's porcelain or whatever that stuff is. It's ceramic. And so we kind of asked, and she's like, you have to take this other box with it, which is like the flush mechanism. And we were like, we didn't think it looked complete. So we were like, yeah,
right.
We don't really
it was an electronic flusher, and it looked pretty empty. You know how it is. People pay to take out parts. But she said we had to take it all for $15. So we did.
So we were like, $15, not bad, right? It turns out which I should have known this before because I've sold flush mechanisms before, the flush mechanism is worth way more than the urinal.
And it was complete.
Yep. And it was complete.
It was just in one of those boxes that had way too much packaging. So
yeah, it just looked empty.
It looked empty, but it wasn't. So it's great. So we sold a urinal already.
Thank God it sold. And it sold for $130. Yep. Free shipping.
Though. So now we could make $300 on the flush.
I'm hoping, yeah.
It's one of those electronic flush mechanisms.
So that was a funny find because I was kind of like, I don't really want it. Yep. And we've already
But that's a good example. We weren't actually specifically out scavenging that day. We were just at like Home Depot, Lowe's.
Yeah.
And we just stopped by Salvation Army on the way home and just happened to run into that. And that's what we all talk about. Scavenging takes time. You always have to be looking.
Right.
You got to go to 10 places to find that one place that has, a $130 a urinal that sells in a week, and you have to spend that time to do that.
I mean, we almost walked out of there with like a t-shirt, you know, like just a t-shirt and like,
some shoes or
some stuff for our house, and so that was cool.
And really, this week was only exciting. We would be the only ones excited about the stuff it's we sell, because we sold a lot of random items that we've had for a long time. That didn't sell for a lot, but every time something sold for $15, I'm like, I can't believe that sold. I'm so
happy. I want it off my shelf. Gone. Like there was stuff. Okay, look, I said I had a 40% off sale. Some stuff sold for $5. I mean, I've had this thing forever. I want it gone, and you know what? $5, fine. Goodbye. Yeah. Done.
So it was nice to kind of like its move. Some of these things that we felt
so the would sale never works. Sell.
Things that we would never buy now.
It's like box lot stuff. It's stuff where you're like, let's just squeeze as much money out of this box lot as possible. And you do a lot of times, It works. But
okay, customer issues this week. We haven't really had any. We did sell a holster to a guy.
Yeah.
And he said in his, I didn't see it, but he bought it. He gave us an offer, we accepted it, and then he said, okay, I need the invoice, but I want it to be free shipping. I told him, we don't do that. He said, I put it in, it's my notes, and I said, and we all know this now, the buyer cannot put
free shipping
because, and then try and trick you, and we just said, that's not eBay policy, I'll cancel it if you want.
And he canceled it. So that kind of sucked.
There you go. But the big thing is, and it's not a big deal for us, but this has happened to other people.
Yeah.
We sell things local pickup.
Right.
Oftentimes big furniture.
Yeah.
One of the rental houses we bought had a big barber's chair in it. A really cool old barber's chair.
It was in a beautiful, like, jade green color.
Right.
I thought I could sell it for so much money.
We've had it for a year for like $2,000. We're at the point of our renovation where I had to get rid of it. So me and the guys took it apart, brought it downstairs.
But you built a ramp to get it outside. Right. This was a thing. This thing weighs a ton.
We put it on eBay for $300. Someone bought it. Some guy in Michigan. He paid for it. And now it's been just a month. Silence.
We haven't heard from him.
And
in
he
a
was
month.
Like, well, maybe I'll come pick it up. We gave him our info so he could see how much it would cost for someone else to come pick this up. It's like 500 pounds.
I mean, it weighs
We haven't heard from him. But this is the deal with a local pickup. We require people pay immediately.
Yes.
And then it doesn't matter.
Now, I will say you can't require them to pay immediately. But we say, look, pay by PayPal, and then we'll figure out when you can come pick it up. Well, they don't have to. It's not like they.
Wait, no, real quick. He didn't give us an offer. He bought it outright, so he paid for it.
You can't have pay immediately on local pickup.
Is that
you
true?
Cannot. It's okay. Not possible.
Okay.
So he did pay very swiftly, but it's not. You cannot have it on there. Really? That is the rule. Everybody else knows that.
Look
except
at me.
Jay.
I could have sworn he paid. Nope. Okay, so then he paid right away.
Right.
Well, anyway, that's what we do, is that we make people pay right away. And then it doesn't matter to us
if they pick it up or not.
If it takes them a month to pick it up, it's really
I want it off my porch. That's for certain. But, he's taking his time. I hope eventually he figures it out. Right. And
the worst that happens is we were kind of in that period of like, we just want to get rid of it. We could have gotten more. If he doesn't come and pick it up, we'll just refund him and put it up for hire. I'm willing to sit on it now.
Now that it's on our porch.
Yeah. Now that it's out of like the house that we were trying to fix up. So just the way it is. Okay. Our coming week.
Yep.
This is, so when we're 60-ish, 70s,
yeah,
we'll hear this podcast and we'll think back of, is this week. We'll be like, remember when we did those things? This is what I'm doing. We're continuing to renovate this house. I'm going to be waking up at 5, go over there, I meet these guys. We have some walls to build. We have just, we have a deck to build.
The deck. So, the deck with the beautiful, most gorgeous wood.
You know, that's why we're not scavenging. We're, like, doing this thing. And then you're here.
Yeah.
Working with our little helper.
Yep. So I'll be... Santa's little helper. So I'll be working with our helper.
Trying to teach her...
Scheduled listings. I'll teach her scheduled listing. I hope that I will start getting her to do titles, because that's... I mean, it sounds crazy, but that's a lot of the work is coming up with a good title.
And we have a box of belts and a box of ties.
And you know what's funny? this is a great story. So the box of belts looks endless. You're just like, I can't believe how many
belts
there are.
It's like all these little snakes just, all wrapped
around. I had to go through it and organize it. So what was funny is there was this really distressed leather belt. It just looked like crap. But to me, that's a style. Someone wants that look. It's already distressed. It's vintage. It looks cool. You picked that belt up and you were like, are you sure someone's going to buy this? Why aren't we selling this in a lot? Or maybe we should get rid of it. And I was like, trust me. It's like a cool biker look. It sold the next day for $25.
It did.
It's the only belt that's sold so far. But belts do well for us. I've noticed that. You know, people
need belts.
People need belts. They want a special style.
Guys,
they want a deal.
Guys, you got to wear belts. Don't be beltless.
Don't do it.
And that's what we'll be doing.
Belts.
So let's go ahead and answer some of the questions that people called in about.
Okay, you can always call us on our voicemail. The phone number is 540-407-8486. And you have 3 minutes to leave a message.
Hey, guys. It's Paul in Atlanta, the lift minch. So I'm ramping up to sell on eBay full time next year, and I've got a couple of newbie questions for you. I'm curious, before you guys hired your helper, what do you guys have a sense of how many items you could list? I'm going to be doing this solo, but I'm wondering how many items do you think you guys could list and ship each when you sort of maxed out? And also, I was wondering, like, what are your costs, if you could share your costs of storage, just like physical storage? I appreciate everything you guys do. Talk to you later.
Okay, so we kind of talked about that in this podcast about, you know, we're still anew at this. So we're a newbies when it comes to hiring help. But the person we have right now is she can photograph 15 items every hour.
Right.
So that's where we're at right now. You know, none of us actually do the whole process at one time. I mean, even I'm the one that takes photos normally and write a description or a title, and then you finish it off.
Right.
So we don't really know exactly how long it takes for one person to do everything.
Yeah.
I'm hoping she can do 10 items an hour from start
to finish.
To a finish, you know, especially if you're giving her stuff that is of the same thing.
Yeah,
and not like a box of super weird
items. I mean, we've done super random stuff and it's very not fun.
Right.
But it gets done.
And, you know, right now we're paying her $10 an hour. So if you think about it, you know, if she's doing 10 items an hour, that would be, you know, a buck an item. So, you know, you have to see if that's good for you. But for us, that makes sense to us with the kind of money we could make if all that stuff sells.
Yeah.
But, you know, I think a lot of it is too, is it's more about, I think when you have a helper, they're looking to you for the process. So sometimes I find when people ask this question, they're coming at it from the angle of like, I don't know what to do.
Right.
I don't know how to do this. Let me hire someone and have them just figure out and they do it.
Yeah.
That's not going to work. What happens is you figure out the it's processed. Then you hire someone and you tell show them what to do. And you even work side by side.
Right.
It's with them. So it's almost like you have a clone of yourself. So if you're a bad clone, a lazy clone, an inefficient clone, your person's not going to be very good, probably.
Right.
So that's how it works in my mind.
I mean, yeah, you have to, if you're going to go full time, I mean, you need to figure out what process works for you and what makes sense for your business.
I mean, something I've noticed when she works, when you two are working side by side, it's normally 3 or 4 hours at a time.
Yeah.
You guys are super efficient. I find it makes you more efficient too.
Because she's there, so I'm working side by side with her, and I'm like, I can't just like go off and do something else. I mean, I got to get these listings up, or else the listings are going to pile up. Like, they have to get up sometime. So that's my dedicated time to do it. It's not like I can be distracted. It's like, you got to be here, you know?
So I find you guys get as much done in 3 to 4 hours as sometimes you'll get done in 8 hours.
Right, right. Yeah, it's good. So about costs, I mean, storage costs, I mean, that just depends on where you're getting storage.
Yeah, it's like Orion says, you can go and look, hear our older episodes. I mean, there's even one called storage, scavenger storage. We live in the country, so storage isn't a problem because we have land and we can build buildings anytime we want or need.
Or use buildings that are on our land already. Yeah. But we have rented storage space. We're currently renting storage space.
We pay $60 a month for a 10x10.
Yeah, 10x10.
Which is super cheap, you know.
Yeah.
But if you live in an urban area, I know those problems will be different, you know. You don't have big backyards, or you don't have room in your house or your garage.
Right.
And all I can say is come on a forum and put that question out there and see what people say.
Yeah.
Some people I know who are serious about this and doing full time, they even rent like warehouse like spaces,
actual big,
like, you know, pay $1,000 a month for, you know, a big, you know, a warehouse space and just a work out of that.
Yep.
AJ and Ryan, I was just calling to see how it turned out with that big lot of markers that you bought a while back. If you think that was a good decision, or if they didn't sell as well as you had hoped. Thanks.
Yeah, Ryan, what's up with those?
Okay, here's the deal. It is a marker death pile, only because I haven't listed them yet.
Okay, real quick, it's not really a death pile. A death pile means, I guess it means it's unlisted, but I've taken pictures of it all
I was about to say that before you interrupted me. Jay took pictures of everything. It was a lot. It's two huge bins. But I haven't listed them yet, so...
Yeah, we just got busy traveling. And is it one of those things where when you think about it, it just sounds very unfun? And
Unfun. Yeah. Very, very unfun. Yeah. But the good thing is there's so many similar things that are just all different colors. It's going to be fast to list. You know, the same title. You've titled everything.
I've titled
it's all,
everything.
It's all ready to go. It's just, honestly, it's about the research. It's about figuring out what prices I want, putting them up there.
And I bet there are some people who are asking, like, well, why doesn't Jay just do it? And here's the deal.
Yeah, that's a great question.
Here's the deal. There are things I don't like to do. I just don't like to list.
Okay, so...
And that's why we, you know, separate out the work and, like...
Yeah. And there are lots of things that I don't like to do. Like, I would not want to be on that renovation site at the other house every day at 7 a.m. Absolutely not. I do not want to do that. I'm so glad you're doing that. I would much rather sit here and list old markers. Right.
So we have a system, and so we each get to keep our own sanity.
Yeah.
And not in anything that one of us thinks is a grind, the other one picks up.
Right.
You know, and so that works for us. So anyway, I'm also very curious as to how they will do.
Yeah.
If anyone is going to want these, like, vintage markers and pens.
I think they will. I think that's why we bought them.
Yeah. It was a great deal no matter what.
Yeah.
But why don't we see how good of a deal it is?
We'll let you know. Trust me.
Hey, guys. This is Mark in Virginia by way of New Hampshire. And love the show. Love the website. Appreciate everything you guys do. Two issues. I tried to sign into the forum and never got an email. to set up my account. Says it was sent. Don't see it. I have Gmail. Check my filters. It's not there. And then secondly, on the blog, I know it's a work in progress. If there's any way you could darken up the font and maybe change the font style, it comes through as very, very light and hard to read, especially if you have older eyes like I do. Other than that, everything's great. Thanks for everything you do. All right, bye.
First of all, welcome from is New Hampshire.
Yeah, New England.
Yes, these are good things. So we talked about it. The font is now fixed. So go check it out and tell us if it's thick. And we even made it bigger, too.
Yes.
Because also my eyes are not getting not great either.
Yeah.
And then as far as, you know, not getting the password. So we've had a couple people email us about that. Oftentimes it's in your spam folder. And if you still aren't seen it, just ask for it again.
Ask for it again and, yeah, say, I forgot my password. You can also email us because if I see your email, I can go in and look on the user list and see if something's caught up or it's caught in a spam filter or something. But just calling in and saying you have a problem is hard because I just can't see that data.
Yeah, so so anyone that's having a problem posting on the forum or starting a membership,
just
email us directly from the blog and we'll...
So it's thescavengerlife@gmail.com and that will get directly to
us. But yeah, it is a work in progress. So please, if you have suggestions, either email us or you can go on the forum itself and under random things.
Random thoughts.
There's like a... there's a topic about, you know, the... it's new, like suggestions for the new...
Yeah.
A forum.
That helps us because there are definitely things that you guys want that we have not thought of.
Yep. All right. Thanks for being with us today. You can check out our blog at scavengerlife.com for all the links we talk about. And you can also join the conversation over there as well in our new forum. You can call and leave a question or comment about something that you heard.
The phone number is 540-407-8486.
So we post this episode every Monday, oftentimes Sunday night if you want to get it early. And on Wednesdays, we post a What Sold It video, and that will show what has been sold over the past week. We used to make them. Lately, we've been having Steve make them, and he does a really good job.
Yeah, he's great.
Some people have been emailing us asking, is Ryan ever going to do it again?
Look, jeez, like...
It's just a lot of work.
It's honestly, when I think about how much time I save not videotaping, when I'm shipping and then editing it, it's great because I have very little time these days. So maybe, I'm not sure.
But I think one way we could get her to maybe start doing it at least sometimes, again, she loves watching other people's. So when we do that post every Wednesday, you can go in the forum category and you can post your own What's Sold.
Yeah.
Because we love to see those and that might motivate us to do another one. You can subscribe to our podcast through iTunes or through YouTube or at whatever podcatcher you may have. you can listen to our other podcasts if you want and you can hear why we're so busy at shampooandbooze.com. That's where we talk about our rental business that is being funded by our eBay business.
Yep.
I cannot stress that enough, how cool that is and how it scares us to death because it's a lot of money. But we take all the profits from our old shoes that we sell on eBay and we're putting it towards our real estate business. And if you want, it's wintertime, if you want to rent our vacation farmhouse, that link is on our blog, and you can rent it, and you can come and stay, have a private, fun time, or if you want to meet us, we'll have dinner. It's with you as well. This podcast is now ending.
In 3, 2, 1.
Goodbye.